As we said, the Nakba or catastrophe in 1948 left the majority of Palestinians in refugee camps, hoping, dreaming of returning to Palestine, while the State of Israel obtained international recognition and became quite a powerful force, joining at one time with Britain and France to attack Egypt when Gamal Abdel Nasser nationalized the Suez Canal. But for most of the Palestinians, this was a period of waiting for redemption, living a lot of them in the West Bank and Gaza as refugees. The West Bank was controlled by Jordan, became part of Jordan, including East Jerusalem, and the Gaza Strip was administered by Egypt. And although the Palestinian Liberation Organization, PLO, was created in 1964, Palestinians were waiting for the Arab world to help them defeat Israel and return to their homes. And of course, the Arab world was not doing much to help them. In 1967, a major event took place that changed and shifted the whole situation. The Six-Day War, Israel claiming preemptively that it was defending itself because it thought the Arab armies were going to attack it. They attacked first and conquered the rest of Palestine. They conquered the West Bank, Gaza, all of the Sinai Peninsula from Egypt, as well as the Golan Heights from Syria. This introduced a whole new dynamic, because now the Palestinian people were living under direct Israeli military occupation. It also created a new international situation where Israel, within its 67 borders, was in control of all of Palestine. So the Zionist intention to keep all of Palestine and make it into a Jewish state was running into conflict both with the indigenous people, the Palestinians who wanted to create a Palestinian state, and with the international community that was willing to accept Israel within the 67 borders, but not to accept its control over the areas it occupied in 1967. This created the basis for what's called the two-state solution. Resolution 242, unanimous by the Security Council, basically said that Israel had to return those lands, and in return, the Palestinians had to accept a state in the West Bank and Gaza. Many people throughout the world thought that the two-state solution was really the best pragmatic solution to the conflict between the Zionists who wanted a Jewish state and the Palestinian Arabs who wanted an Arab state. Even though the Arab state was going to be smaller, 22% of the land, it was felt that it was a reasonable compromise. The problem is that with Israel in control of all of Palestine, Jewish settlers started setting up throughout the occupied territories Jewish settlements. These were not Israeli settlements. These were basically areas where Jews only would live. The entire international community, including the United States, considered those settlements to be illegal, violation of international law, totally unfair, definitely an obstacle to peace. But most importantly, they were undermining the possibility of a historic compromise between Jews and Arabs along the lines of a two-state solution. Under international law, it was very clear. Israel, as an occupying power, had to abide by the Fourth Geneva Convention, cannot move its civilian population into those areas, cannot change the situation on the ground. But Israel felt it had enough power and enough backing from the United States to do all these things, including, and this is very significant for us, the annexation of East Jerusalem and making it part of the State of Israel without granting its residents Israeli citizenship. So we now have a situation where Palestinians are living under military occupation, where they are facing continuing settlement activity and a gradual annexation into Israel, and at the same time, their national feelings, their desire for freedom and independence was not becoming any less, it was becoming greater, and they were demanding that they have freedom, that they have self-determination, that the international community should help them, that there should be a new reality, and movement towards peace, movement towards resolution of the conflict was following the lines of seeking a two-state solution, one for Palestinians in the West Bank and Gaza, one for Israel in what was pre-67 borders, and maybe some kind of sharing of Jerusalem and some kind of repatriation or reparation for the refugees who could come back or take compensation.